Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea.
Someone needs to invent a new vibrator.
During a 60-second elevator pitch.
Time's up.
Pitching in this elevator is hard.
After each pitch, it takes just one investor to say yes to open the doors and hear more.
I'm in.
But only the ones who say yes can go on and invest. Straight from home or the home office.
When the world turns upside down, women still need bras and undies.
This has never happened in the history of elevator pitch.
This is going to be so awesome.
It's Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch with support from Michigan Economic Development Corporation and U.S. Bank.
Going up.
Welcome to a work-from-home edition of Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch. We have four amazing investors ready to dish out some money, so let's hear the first pitch.
Their 60 seconds begins now.
Hey everybody, I'm Randall Shapiro.
I'm Riley Kuffner.
And we're excited today to tell you about our company, Mirabel.
At the moment, our food system is a total mess. Fresh food is grown over 1,000 miles away. It's sprayed with harmful chemicals, there's massive amounts of waste, and this whole system is damaging the environment.
We need something better. Luckily, we've talked to over 1,000 people who want to grow their own food, but they don't have the space, time, or knowledge to do so in their everyday environment.
That's where we come in. Mirabel designs fully autonomous gardens that can grow fresh food anywhere. Our first product is a beautiful wall garden, specially designed for greens, herbs, and microgreens.
Yeah, we launched this product at CES this year, where we were called one of the top 5 coolest startups by Entrepreneur Magazine. Subsequently, we sold around 75 units and received major interest from real estate developers, restaurants, and commercial builders alike.
We've already financed product development. Today, we're asking for $100,000 to expand customer trials in exchange for a 20% discount on our seed raise that we're opening in the new year.
We hope you join us along this journey. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
One. Time's up.
Who's hungry to do a deal with those two guys?
I thought they had a great pitch. They were really enthusiastic, and it sounds like they have an interesting product.
I love the fact that they talked about some of the research that they did. They weren't just speaking anecdotally about the things that they had been doing. They had some data.
Great to see that they've invested or they've started to sell the product. I think they said 75 units or so initially.
I'd be interested to hear more about their business model, how they're pricing this, and what sort of revenue 75 units represents.
We gotta make a decision. Who wants to open the doors?
Okay, I'm in.
I'm in.
I'm in.
Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
First of all, great pitch. When it comes to the valuation, you said a 20% discount for $100K. What is the vehicle that you're using?
The plan is actually to raise around $2 to $3 million at around an $8 to $10 million post-money valuation.
You said you've sold 75 units.
Mostly our product sales are going to be direct to consumer. So those 75 units have come in the form of early deposits from customers who have basically pre-ordered the device.
Do you actually have a working prototype of this? And can that working prototype scale?
So these units are about 30 inches by 30 inches. They hang on the wall, just kind of like a picture frame, and they can grow 2 pounds of food each month.
What does it cost all in to build one of these units, your bomb? And what are you going to retail it for?
So the costs right now are right around $200 to build one of these units. We're retailing for $395.
Are these meant to be in homes or restaurants? I was unclear about the B2B or B2C.
So we're a full-fledged B2C company in terms of starting our product sales, but we have received interest from some restaurants and a couple commercial builders that want to build these into the wall themselves. So that's where that kind of angle has come from.
Okay, investors, this is the time. Is anybody prepared to make an offer?
I think it's definitely something that deserves to see the light of day, but this is just too early for me.
I think the product is really innovative, but I would like to see more actual traction, more actual sales before investing.
I agree with Ali. I think this could be an interesting way to help solve the food desert issue in a lot of minority communities. I think that would be interesting for me, but at present, I'm not interested.
You had a lot of excitement when you first started. What do you think happened?
I think it has to do a little bit with our standing. You know, we raised a little bit of capital and, you know, we're in the process of really deploying that and making the progress that we want to make. I think, you know, it was probably a little bit too early for the judges.
Do you think you were a little all over the place, though? I mean, you were talking about a lot of different stuff.
Yeah, I think that you're right. I think having a little bit more concise probably would have been better. Yeah.
Time to move on to the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now.
Hello, my name is Mahesh Narayanan. I'm the president and CEO of PathVax. Cell and gene therapies have revolutionized precision medicine and have saved thousands of lives, but they don't work as well for a lot of patients, and some of these drugs can cost as much as $500,000 per patient. The problem for a lot of this is because we've been using viruses to deliver and develop these type of treatments for patients. As you can see from this pandemic, viruses aren't that great for humans. So PepVax has developed a novel DNA-based drug delivery platform called SmartMid to help us deliver these type of treatments into patients more safely and more affordably by bringing some of these costs down to about a fifth of the current prices. This patent-pending technology has been licensed to multiple universities and partners, helping us generate revenue. We are currently looking for a $250,000 convertible note as part of our Series A to help us grow. And we're looking to expand our team, our IP portfolio, and help us deliver this type of treatments into patients much more safely and much more effectively. Please join PepVax. Delivery is in our DNA.
Time's up.
Investors, I'd love to hear your take on this one.
So Peter, what I understood is that this is for new drug discovery, for clinical trials, and I think he said for cell gene therapy, but I'm a little confused.
I think he needs to work on his pitch and making it more clear for the average investor.
If we look at healthcare in this country, if you can reduce the cost significantly, there could be something there. But I do agree with Ali that this was just not a good pitch.
I felt like he was pitching something that had to do with how this DNA sequence is healthier. But still, it was, you know, a bit inarticulate.
We got to make a decision. Who wants to open the doors? Okay, guys, sounds like everybody agrees. Let's send them down.
Going down.
Mahesh, unfortunately, all four investors decided to send you down. They were all confused.
Well, a lot of what we're doing is pretty hard science, and so it's kind of hard to put all that together in 1 minute.
You made a comment about you were looking to raise $250,000 as part of your Series A, but you said it was a $250,000 convertible note.
It's actually a $4 million Series A. We already have a lead investor for 3.5, and we have currently $500,000 open.
Why wouldn't you have said that? That's such an important piece of information.
I was focusing on it. Should I talk about the company or should I talk about the round? Probably should have talked about round a little bit more, but I think I went for the company instead. So that was probably on me.
Michigan has a fantastic business culture.
Michigan's a place where we make things.
Anyone should consider starting a business in Michigan.
Everybody helps each other.
Moving on. Next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now.
Hi, I'm Polly Rodriguez, the CEO and co-founder of Unbound, a D2C sexual wellness company that makes 50 vibrators, lubricants, and accessories. We've done $10 million in sales and hit profitability. The $50 billion sex toy industry has existed for over 100 years, but it's always been run by old white men who make pink phallic products for women. This is actually one of the best sellers in the market today. And in addition to the design being disgusting, it also contains carcinogens because vibrators are not regulated by the FDA, which is what makes Unbound different. We make affordable, body-safe products using innovation in technology and design. We place second at TechCrunch Disrupt and also have 2 patents filed and 8 trademarks. Today, I'm asking for $500,000 in exchange for 3% of our company so we can build out 10 new products in our pipeline next year. Men have Viagra, Hims, Roman, Playboy, Hustler, and Manscaping. Help us build the first billion-dollar brand that exists for the other 50% of the population. Help us build Unbound.
Time's up.
I thought that that was an amazing pitch, and I love the valuation. I mean, she is doing $10 million in sales, and she's putting herself at a $16.6 million valuation. That sounds great to me.
I'm a little confused over the valuation. I get what you're saying, Allie, on a multiple basis on revenue, but I think I'd like to drill down into profitability and maybe exit strategy to get a little more comfortable there.
I think she had a phenomenal pitch. I love that she is breaking through this male-dominated sex toy industry.
The sales seem to be impressive. Definitely agree that we do need to learn more about what their profit margins are.
Okay, who wants to open the doors?
I'm in.
I'm in on this one.
I'm also in.
I'm in.
Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Amazing.
Well, you have a lot of excitement from our four investors.
Yay!
First of all, congratulations. $10 million in sales is pretty awesome.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.
I'd love to hear your founder story. How did you get involved in this? What made you go into this business?
So when I was 21 years old, I went through a stage 3 colorectal cancer diagnosis, and the radiation sent me through menopause, but none of my doctors told me that. They just said I would never be able to have children. And so I found myself on Google trying to figure out what was going on, and went to the only place in my hometown of St. Louis that sold these products, which was just a really mortifying shopping experience. And so just saw that there was a huge opportunity to create a much more approachable, elevated brand that was designing more innovative products.
How many products do you currently carry?
Right now we have 50 SKUs spanning vibrators, lubricants, and accessories. On average, each customer spends about $66 on our website. So with that AOV versus CAC, we are profitable on the first purchase.
Investors, are one of you prepared to make a deal?
Polly, what I'm prepared to offer you is $500,000 in financing secured against the machine tool, which will also award me the 3% equity that you've offered, and I'd like to join your board.
Polly, I'm gonna best that, and I'm actually gonna offer you $500,000 for equity in your company at 3%. I'd also like a board seat.
Marilyn and Avia, you two are gonna say something. You better say it right now.
I think that Ali comes to the table with a really compelling offer.
This one's a little too rich for my blood. I'm gonna pass.
It looks like Ross is offering $500,000 in the form of financing for the 3%, and Allie is offering you the $500,000 for the straight 3%. Do you want to take one of those two deals?
I think I want to go with Allie's deal, mostly because I really appreciate and admire that you've worked with 14 female founders in the past. And so, yeah, Allie, we'd be really excited to work with you on this.
Amazing. And I'm from St. Louis, too.
You had 4 judges that wanted to open the doors, 2 offers. Do you feel that by having this additional $500,000, it's gonna allow you just to get so far along with the company?
Oh, I mean, this is a stepping stone. We're gonna be huge, but our whole MO is to be capital efficient. We've really only ever tried to raise what we actually need and really putting that money towards innovation as opposed to just dumping tons of money into paid acquisition. So, I'm excited.
And we all wish you the best of luck with the next chapter of the company.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Let's go, investors. Next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Cohen.
I'm Isaac Cohen.
We are the co-founders of We Make Impact, co-creating a world where everyone has access to clean water and no one is living in extreme poverty.
Now, over the years, Jimmy and I have raised millions of dollars for charities all over the world. There's always been a consistent lack of transparency for where donations are making their direct impacts.
Right, and everyone's heard this story. So that's why We Make Impact is bridging the gap between donors and donees through personalized video updates. And we're not just giving people water. This is the key. We're empowering people to start their own water micro franchises through entrepreneurship training, which is included in each of their sales, creating a ripple effect of positive change.
So our projects have been endorsed by celebrities like Les Brown. And our team includes senior executives from companies like Microsoft, Oracle, and SAP. We've built a gamified application that can scale our outreach, creating even more of a ripple effect. And even Google's given us tens of thousands of dollars every month for their free Google Ad Grants program. We're asking you for $100,000. We're willing to offer a royalty, so
Time's up.
My head's spinning, and that's not a good thing.
I thought that the pitch could have been a lot more focused. I love the problem that they're trying to solve, but without knowing what they want to do, it's really hard to assess.
There's just so much we don't know about the company.
I think they've got a lot of enthusiasm, but that does not a business make.
Is anyone interested in opening the doors and hearing more? Well, it looks like We Make Impact did not have the impact with our investors.
Going down.
All the investors were absolutely confused on what is the product?
Absolutely, yeah, we should have just simplified when we tried to jam everything into that 60-second pitch.
All right.
Coming up on the next Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
I'm actually a little concerned about having a fiance duo as co-founders.
Ross, he just shut you down.
And to apply for season 7, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.